الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. There is a narration in Jami' al-Tirmidhi in which Sayyidina Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala an, he comes to the blessed court of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he mentions that he frequently recites Durood Sharif in abundance upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But then he asks a question. He says, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, فَكَمْ أَجْعَلُ لَكَ مِنْ صَلَاتِ. How much time should I devote to this activity, reciting Durood Sharif, peace and blessings upon you? And the Prophet ﷺ replied, مَا شِئْتَ. As much as you like, wherever you find convenient for you. He said, is a fourth of my time sufficient for this activity? The Prophet ﷺ said, again, مَا شِئْتَ. As much as you like. فَإِنْ زِدْتَ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ. But if you increase upon this, increase upon a fourth of your time in reciting Durood Sharif, then this will be better for you. Then he said, فَالنِّصْف. How about if I spend half of my time after fulfilling my obligations, reading Salah, looking after my family, those things which are obligatory, necessary upon me, after fulfilling those, what if I spend half of my time in reciting peace and blessings upon you? And again, the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا شِئْتَ. As much as you like. But if you increase this, even if you increase this, meaning spending half your time, فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ. This would be better for you. So then he asks, what about two-thirds of my time? If I spend two-thirds of my time spent reciting Durood Sharif upon you, is this sufficient? The Prophet ﷺ said, whatever you like. Again, he left it open. It's up to you. It's entirely up to you. It's your decision. But then he said, فَإِنْ زِدْتَ. But if you increase it, then this is better for you. Subhanallah. This shows the love of the Prophet ﷺ for this activity, for this action of reciting Durood Sharif. Then the Sahabi, Sayyidina Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala, and he states, أَجْعَلُ لَكَ صَلَاتِي كُلَّهَا. يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. I will devote all my time after fulfilling the faraid, after fulfilling those things which are obligatory upon me and necessary for me to do. I will spend all my time in reciting peace and blessings upon you. And the Prophet ﷺ replied and said, if this is the case, if you are going to spend all your time reciting Durood Sharif upon me, then this will suffice to remove all your sorrows, all your difficulties, your calamities. وَيُخْفَرُ ذَنْبُكَ. And your sins will be forgiven as well. Subhanallah al-Azim. My viewers of Madani channel, in this Hadith Sharif, we learn that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves those who recite Durood Sharif upon him in abundance. He loves this action. This is why he asked the Sahabi to continue doing so. The more you recite, the better it will be for you. And also, we learn that Durood Sharif is a remedy for removing all our griefs and sorrows. And inshallah, by means of the recitation of Durood Sharif, our sins will be forgiven as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable all of us to recite Durood Sharif in abundance and especially take time out in our daily lives so that we can devote a portion of our day just to reciting Durood Sharif upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, once again we are here to learn about the blessed life of Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem. So far we've covered different aspects of his life, his knowledge, his blessed nikah to Sayyidah Fatima radiallahu anha, his fada'il, his virtues. Inshallah azza wa jal, in this episode, we will cover the karamat, the saintly miracles of Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem. Now the ulama have written entire books based on the miracles of the awliya-i kiram rahimahumullahu ta'ala. And of course, the sahaba-i kiram alayhim ridwan, they are afdalul awliya. they are the highest ranking awliya of this ummah. And as such, they also performed many, many miracles throughout their lives. Once there was a heavy flood in the river Euphrates, and the people became worried. This was causing them loss. Their fields were being destroyed. So they came to the court of Mawla Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem and requested, they humbly requested for his help. He karamallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem stood up at once and he got dressed. But what clothing did he actually wear? Subhanallah. It's mentioned that he wore the blessed robe, the jubba sharif of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the sacred turban, the imama sharif, and a shawl. He radiallahu anhu then mounted his horse. He got onto his horse. Hassanayn Karimain radiallahu ta'ala, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, they also accompanied him. When they reached the river Euphrates, the bank of the river Euphrates, he radiallahu ta'ala an offered 2 rakat nafal. So he performed worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then headed towards the bridge of Al-Furat. When he reached the bridge, Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem pointed his staff towards the river. He pointed his staff towards the river. And this all of a sudden lowered the water level that was caused by this flood. The water reached a very high level. And it actually lowered it by 1 yard. After this, he radiallahu ta'ala again pointed the staff towards the river. All he did was point the staff towards it. And again, it lowered by 1 yard. Subhanallah. The third time, he radiallahu ta'ala an pointed the blessed staff towards the river and the water lowered by more than 3 yards. Subhanallah. And the flood completely subsided. It stopped. And the people requested, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, please stop now. If you do any more, then we will have different problems. We won't have no water left. Allahu Akbar. So this was a great miracle of Mawla Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem. And before I move on and actually mention other miracles of this great Sahabi Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiyallahu ta'ala an, I would like to just mention a bit about the concept of miracles in Islam. What is a miracle? Some people, when they hear about these supernatural acts, they become confused. Did this really happen? How is this possible? Because their mind cannot comprehend it. So first and foremost, it is important to note that karamate awliya, miracles of the saints of Islam, the awliya, these are proven from the Quran Sharif itself. They have been documented in the Quran Sharif itself. There are many ahadith-e kareema, sayings of the noble Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam regarding the power of the awliya Allah. Inshallah, I will now present these. First of all, a saintly miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself mentions in the Quran Sharif. Sayyida Maryam radiallahu ta'ala anha, a very high ranking saint, one of the most important figures in terms of women in Islam. It's mentioned in Surah Ali Imran, verse 37. When Zakariya alayhi salam, who is responsible for looking after Sayyida Maryam radiallahu anha, whenever he would enter her room, the chamber where she would perform worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran states, كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب, whenever he would enter her chamber, وجد عندها رزقا, he would find food there. And the ulama, the mufassirun, they mention that this was no ordinary food. It was fruit that was not in the season at that moment, meaning you couldn't find that fruit anywhere else. And Sayyida Maryam radiallahu anha, she had that food with her. So an amazing event. Sayyiduna Zakariya alayhi salam, he asked, Anna laki hadha? Where has this come from? Nobody in these lands has these provisions, has this type of food. It's not the season for it. How have you been able to get a hold of this? And subhanAllah, she said the very famous words the Quran mentions as well. Qalat huwa min indillah. This has come from Allah Jalla wa Ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided me with this. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants whomsoever he wants sustenance without account, without accountability. Subhanallah al-Azim. There are many, many other verses of the Quran which show the miracles of the awliya Allah. For example, the waqiyah of the Ashab al-Kahf, how they stayed in the cave for more than 300 years and nothing happened to them. There is the waqia of Sayyidina Asif bin Barkhiya radiallahu anhu, the minister of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, how he was able to bring the throne of Bilqis before the blink of an eye. Very, very great miracle. The definition of karamat, that this is something that goes against the norm. Khariqun lil'ada. It's something that is not understood by the mind. When you see something and you think, this is not possible, how is this person doing it? It goes against the norm. Supernatural act. And then he says, وَنُؤْمِنُ بِمَا جَاءَ مِنْ كَرَامَاتِهِمْ وَالصَّحَ عَنِ الثِّقَاتِ مِنْ رِوَايَاتِهِمْ. He mentions that we believe as Muslims, the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, he actually mentions these words. We believe in the karamat of the awliyaullah, the saints of Islam. And we accept those narrations that have reached us through trustworthy narrators regarding the karamat of the awliyaullah. So once it is established that from the early generations, this concept of miracles was clear. They had no doubt about it. No satanic whispers affected them. Inshallah, I will mention a few narrations which show the karamat of the early Sahaba ikiram alayhim ridwan. It is mentioned that once Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he is sitting on the Mimbar Sharif in Madinatul Munawwara, Zadaha Allahu sharafan wa ta'zima. And a Muslim army has gone to war in a place called Nahawand. And while sitting in Medina Sharif, he is able to observe and see what is going on. And when he saw that the enemy were about to attack, he called out, he helped the Muslim army, and he said, watch out for the enemy behind the mountain. And Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, it's mentioned that the army, they heard the voice of Sayyidina Umar many, many miles away, and they were able to save themselves from the attack of the enemy, and they were actually victorious as well. So a great miracle of Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab, that he was able to make his voice reach hundreds of miles away. He was able to see the Muslim army hundreds of miles away. Another miracle, it is mentioned, and this is by a great scholar, Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. When it came to the time of his death, his passing away from this world, he states that the shaitan came, and we know from narrations that shaitan comes at this moment and tries to attack a person. He tries to take the iman away of a person. So he comes to Sayyiduna Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi alayhi, and he's trying to confuse him. He said, you believe in Allah Jalla wa Ala, what are the proofs for this? People call you Imam al-Mutakallimin, and they have special titles for you. Prove to me that Allah exists. So he's confusing and trying to confuse Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi alayhi at this very critical point. He's about to leave this world. And Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi alayhi states that I gave him an answer. Then he asked me again. I gave him another answer. And eventually he asked me over 300 times for proofs, and I gave him a proof each time. Then I thought, this is it. He's about to win the battle. He's confusing me. And all the while, the Shaykh of Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi alayhi, Najmuddin al-Kubra rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he is observing this. He's also miles away. He's performing wuzu. And he is observing the tricks of shaitan upon his murid. And he sees this. And he says, oh Fakhruddin, he calls out to him, oh Fakhruddin, why don't you just say to shaitan that I believe in Allah Azza wa Jal without any proof? I don't need a proof for this. I believe in Allah. And Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullah alayhi said this, and he won the battle against shaitan at this very critical moment. So again, we learn from this, the karamat of the awliya Allah. They are able to see from far away. They're able to help people from a far distance. And it's something that is against the norm. Again, we can't understand it. We can't comprehend it. Another miracle, Imam Suyuti rahmatullah alayhi, a very famous scholar, a muhaddis, mufassir, someone who's a prolific writer, and we have many of his books today. They have reached us, alhamdulillah, azza wa jal. A miracle is narrated regarding him. On one occasion, he was in Misr. He was in Misr, which is known as modern-day Egypt. Qahira, in fact, the capital. And from there, he wanted to go to the house of Allah, Baytullah Sharif. And he went, it's documented, he went from Misr, Qahira, all the way to Baytullah Sharif in just a few steps. Meaning today, you need to get on the plane, you need to travel for a number of hours, may even stop over in a different country. It's a long journey. And in the past, it was an even longer journey. It took people 3 or 4 months to get to their destination, especially to the Haramain Sharifain and the Holy Lands. And here, Imam Suyuti Rahmatullah Ali, showing the karamat, the blessings of Allah upon him, that Allah has bestowed him with such immense quality and power, he travels all the way from his homeland to Baytullah Sharif in just a few steps. And this miracle is very well documented as well. It's famous and it's known as Tayyul Ard. When the earth becomes shortened, the earth becomes shortened for the awliya-i kiram, and they are able to cover large distances in a short space of time. Subhanallah. Another miracle of Sayyiduna Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiyallahu ta'ala, Ghawth-e Azam rahmatullah alayh. There are many, many miracles attributed to him. But one I would like to mention, Ghawth-e Azam radiyallahu anhu stated once, لو كشف عورة مريدي في المشرق وأنا في المغرب لستبتها. Sayyiduna Ghawth-e Azam radiyallahu anhu states that if my murid, if my disciple, if he was in the east and he was about to be exposed, something was about to happen to him, he was about to meet some calamity, then I, being in the west, maybe miles away from me, thousands of miles away from me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted me this power, this ability, that I will go and save him from being exposed. I will go and I will aid my murid and help him. Subhanallah al-Azim. So my dear brothers in Islam, I hope that you are clear about this concept of karamat and you are not going to be attacked by the whispers of shaitan. Someone might say that how are they able to see from far? How are they able to hear from far? How are they able to reach a distant place in such a short amount of time? Inshallah, I will present a hadith from Bukhari Sharif. So listen very carefully. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions, "Man aada li waliyan faqad aadantuhu bil harb." Allah jalla wa ala says, "Whoever has enmity for a friend of mine, whoever has a grudge for a friend of mine, then I will declare war against him. I will declare war against him." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues and mentions that Allah jalla wa ala said, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَدْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. That my slave, my servant, he continues to gain closeness to me. How? Through acting upon the fara'id. He acts upon the fara'id. He keeps continuing to fulfill his obligations. And then he gains closeness to me. Thereafter, the Prophet ﷺ said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he continues to gain this closeness through nawafil, voluntary, supererogatory worship. When he performs nawafil, then his darajat are increased further and he gains more of a closeness. Until there comes a time, hatta uhibbahu. There comes a time where I love him. I hold him dear. Fa'idha ahbabtuhu. When I love him. Allah Jalla ala is saying, when I love this slave of mine, kuntu سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. I become the ears by means of which he hears. I will clarify what this means, what the muhaddithin kiram have said regards to this hadith. But at the moment, I will mention the hadith of the narration itself. Then, وَبَصْرَهُ الَّذِي يَبْصُرُ بِهِ. I become his eyes by means of which he sees. وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا. Become his hands by means of which he grabs. وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا. I become his feet by means of which he walks. وَلَئِن سَأَلَنِي. And if you were to ask me, لَأُعْطِيَنَّهُ. I will most definitely give it to him. وَلَئِن إِسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ. And if he seeks refuge in me, if he seeks refuge, I will provide refuge to him. Subhanallah al-Azim. You may be thinking, how does this hadith sharif prove the point that we were mentioning earlier, that the awliya Allah can see from far, can hear from far, it can travel far distances in a short space of time. Imam Al-Dhahabi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi mentions in the commentary of this hadith that what it actually means is Allah does not literally become his eyes, his ears, his hands and feet. In fact, the jalal, the qudra of Allah's light enter into the eyes of that person, enter into the ears of that person, into the feet and the hands of that person. And then through this light, this power of the qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the light of this power, he is able to see far distances. He is able to hear things that are very far distant. He is able to travel long distances in a short space of time. So this is the correct understanding. And this is how, when we read about these miracles, shaitan is not able to attack us, because we have the right idea regarding this concept. Back to the topic about the karamat of Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem. Now they are very numerous. There is a lot of karamat narrated. It's mentioned that once Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem, he loved the Quran Sharif, always recited the Quran Sharif. He had immense love for it. But the rapid speed in which he recited the Quran Sharif, Allahu Akbar. The ulama mentioned that when he would mount his horse, before fully mounting the horse, he would complete one recitation of the Quran Sharif before fully mounting the horse. Subhanallah al-Azim. Just imagine, this is not normal. This is not something that me and you can do. We cannot just pick up the Quran Sharif and recite it all within 5 minutes, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. No, it's not possible for us. But for the awliya-i kiram, rahimahullah ta'ala, such things are possible. And this is well documented. Sayyidina Ali, before he even fully mounted his horse, one complete recitation of the Quran Sharif. Subhanallah. Now, in the first miracle that we mentioned, he helped the people. There was a flood, and he helped make the flood go away. And because of this reason, one of his titles was Mawla Mushkil Kusha. He was a helper of the people. He was someone who assisted and aided the people. Now again, shaitan is at work all the time. Shaitan is always trying to create wasawis, whispers in the hearts and minds of people. And he may place a whisper into the mind and say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the real helper. Allah is the one who assists. How can you claim that the creation is on a level with Allah and is also a helper? This is an attack of the shaitan. Remember, such attacks, sometimes shaitan even places verses of the Quran in a person's mind. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. That indeed, we only worship you. We only seek help from you. But then why do we turn to others? Why are people telling us about Sayyiduna Ali being a helper? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only source for help. How can we turn to somebody else? But remember, my dear brothers, we must avoid these whispers. And if they ever come into our minds, we must not allow them to settle, because then it's very dangerous. A person will lose out on many blessings. And in fact, he could actually reach a point where he adopts the wrong belief, the wrong aqidah regarding this issue. Now remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, he is mentioning that he in reality is the most important. He is the one who really helps. Everybody else who helps, they help through the giving of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the bestowal of Allah. So even the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he would say and mention the favors of Allah upon him, he would say, this is a blessing of Allah. I'm not boastful about this. La fakhra. I will be the master of the children of Adam alayhi salam on yawm al-qiyamah. But I am not boasting about this. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who bestows these qualities upon his chosen people. So we must not let these wasawis settle in our hearts. We can refer to somebody else as a helper. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself said, Man kuntu mawlahu fa'aliyun mawlah. That for whomsoever I am his master, Sayyiduna Ali radiallahu anhu is also his master. So there's nothing wrong with calling Sayyiduna Ali Mawla Ali, Mushkil Kusha, saying he's a helper, he's our master, he will help us through our difficulties. This is a correct aqidah, and we must adopt this if we want to attain salvation. So today we heard just a bit about the karamat of Sayyiduna Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahu al-kareem, and then how karamat are proven through the Quran, the verses, the ahadith, and towards the end we just covered how we can seek help from others. If there was forbidden to do so, then nobody could survive in this world. You will not be able to go to the doctors. You will not be able to go for anybody to help. You will not be able to help anybody yourself. You will not be able to take help from anybody. So it's very, very important to know the correct beliefs regarding these issues. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us all to take time out to learn sacred knowledge and to learn about these great personalities. Inshallah, when we learn about their lives, we'll be inspired. We'll be inspired to travel on their path. And by traveling on their path, inshallah, we will reach that thing which is promised for the believers, paradise, al-firdausul a'la. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act upon what has been said. Ameen, bijahin nabiyyil ameen, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم.